Sacrifices that your son made in our behalf, Father. Father, we want to thank you for all the things that you do for us that we know and that we don't know. Father, we want to thank you for Reverend Snowden and his family this morning, Father. Father, we ask for a special prayer out for Reverend Wiley and his family this morning. Yes. Let them know that you're in there, that they are in your thoughts, and that they are in our thoughts and prayers. Father, we ask that you bless the sick and afflicted all over the world today. We ask that you bless all of the people that are cold this morning, Father. Father, we know that there's people cold, hungry, and homeless. But we ask that you look on them and let them know that you are still God, that you're still on the throne, and that you're still in control, Father. Father, we ask that you bless our military and our government this morning. Bless the outgoing government officials and the incoming government officials. Let them know that their will should be your will and that they should be the same, Father. Father, these things and all other things we ask in your Son Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Amen. Remain standing for reading on response reading. Come out of John 14, 18 through 24. Is in your program. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Congregation.
Before long, the world will not see me anymore, but you will see me, because I live, you also will live.
On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I am in you. Congregation.
Whoever has my commands and keeps them is the one who loves me. The one who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I too will love them and show myself to them.
Then Judas, not Judas Iscariot, said, but Lord, why do you intend to show yourself to us and not to the world? Congregation.
Jesus replied, anyone who loves me will obey my teaching. My Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them.
All?
Anyone who loves my love will not obey my teaching. These words you hear are not my own. They belong to the Father who sent me.
And this evening, may the Lord have a blessing and lead to the doers of the world.
is everlasting. He is omnipresent. He is omnipotent. He is omnipowerful. He is our one and only God.
Yes, he is.
I don't have any announcements. Besides give it up to our two ushers back in the back. They have graduated. So thank you guys for sticking through it. I know y'all had a little bit of a time doing it on the computers, virtual and everything, but y'all made it. Thank you so much for your dedication. They also were saying that their graduation or their ceremony is going to be Sunday, December 4th.
That's the first Sunday.
That's the first Sunday, but it won't be here. So you can actually get with one of them and they can give you like the details and the time and everything if you want to stop by and see them, their ceremony. I don't know if it'll be at the same time. We'll be having church or not, hopefully not.
No, 3 o'clock.
Okay.
At New Jerusalem.
All right. If you guys don't know where the New Jerusalem is, since they moved, it's right there on Martin Luther King in Lake Mead.
Also.
Get you up here, I'm off. Thank you, sir.
You can't help me get past the know a lot of man.
So it's on Martin Luther King and Lake Mead. It's right across the street from the post office, right up the street, right behind Mario's, a little bit down from Mario's, that little light purple or lavender building that they built at 3 p.m.
2 p.m.
Is it at 2?
2.
They gotta be there too.
Well, they gotta be there.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah.
You not tell you, Pastor, no?
So, disregard two is gonna be 3 if you wanna go see them at New Jerusalem. That's gonna be Sunday, December 4th. See them come, you know, show support for them because they did it. They stepped up and they did it. They took, you know, time out of their schedules and so forth to do it. So if you're able to, please come out. As far as our prayer and bereavement list, please, you know, let me know if it needs to be updated, if anyone needs to be added, if anyone needs to be removed. Like I said, I try to wait until Saturday evening to get it done. But if something happens throughout, you know, Saturday night and the wee hours of Saturday morning, Sunday morning, please let me know as soon as you see me in here so I can get it handwritten in and then get it updated on the formal list for the following week. With that being said, please pray for our pastor and family. Please pray for my nerves and my patience. Please pray for Reverend Wiley and his family, and please continue to pray for him and that God heals him so he can come back into, you know, in here with us. We miss him, and hopefully, you know, we'll be able to see him soon before this year is out, because we almost done with this year. Please continue to pray for Leo Dodson, Christopher Smith, Eric Smith, Jerry Eagle, Courtney Warnwood, Sister Olga Ortiz, Joyce Terry, Willie Ely, the Wilson and Lewis family, Louise Fuller, Demetrius Sattler, Major Marcus, Mary Phillips, Lawrence Pugh. Please continue to pray for the family of Latoria Marsh during their time of bereavement. Please pray for Sister Noriko Johnson, her mother, and that whatever she is going through, that she comes out on the other side healed. Amen. Please continue to pray for our church, its members, the members that you see here, the members that you don't see here. If they are going through something, please, you know, pray that God puts it on their heart and on their souls that they have to come home. They have to be spiritually fed, so that they can grow. Whatever trials and tribulations that they're going through, they have to hand it over to the Lord. We cannot do it by ourselves. I know we try, we think we can, but we cannot. We only create a bigger mess and still end up having to go to him at the end. Please continue to pray for our city, our state, our country, and the rest of the world. I know it's probably a year or so away, but please pray for the 2024 election. I know y'all seen the announcement. I don't know, you know. how many people are active on social media, but you know, social media. So looking at some of the comments of our fellow people and how they wanted to vote for you know who, just because they got a couple of thousands of dollars for a stimulus check when we were in the middle of a pandemic that could have probably been avoided had he listened to things that was pre-warned to him before, but they don't see that. So he got their vote for a couple of thousand dollars. It's crazy. Please, pray for us. I know our state, I know we just got through, our primary elections. Please pray that the people that were placed in do what they're supposed to do, doing the right things. Help us come out of this on the other side better and stronger. With that being said, I'll hand you over to our pastor, Reverend Carl M. Snowden Sr.
And the church said, amen.
Amen.
It's good to be in the house of the Lord.
So, one more
time. I was just listening to her when she was talking about trying to get back in there. How he gave out stimulus check. But yesterday on the radio, I heard him talk about how a lot of these kids and people that had school loans and stuff like that, and how they're going to give them forgiveness. And then they turn around and have two judges say they can't do that. They got all these youngsters and people to vote for them thinking they're going to get the forgiveness program. And now, but you got to be careful who you vote for.
That's right.
But those was the judges that old boy put in. That wasn't Big Mike didn't put them in. Those were the judges old boy put in.
That's what it was said. But, you know, we just don't know what's going on and everything. And so if I can't hardly pronounce Johnny, and I've been trying to pronounce your name. Rico's been going in 2 weeks. You be going leaving to go about your mother. And we're sorry to hear that. We'll be praying for you. So, Cliff, Mom, with you, or are you going by yourself?
I'm by family.
Oh, you're going to leave him here?
Yeah,
I'll leave him. He said I would cause more problems.
Oh, they brought him with us. I thought he was hitting him over there in the United States. I don't know how y'all going to work out. You're going to be still practicing with them?
I'm going to be still practicing. Until she tells me I have to go back to Japan, whatever, later on, I will.
Okay.
And I have a family of three I have to take care of.
We pray that everything work out. And so since we're going to help you out on the trip a little bit. And everything. So God is good
all the time.
And we try to do and to try to support our own if we can. God supports us. We have to look out for each other. If we don't, who will? I mean, everybody called here. See, y'all don't hear it. Me and Mike be knowing. And Mike, well, what they want this time? I have people calling me. Coming Christmas coming up, everybody know Love Community Baptist Church. I said, well, where you get? Oh, it's in the directory. I said myself, I don't remember putting it in the directory. And people have a lot of problems, but like I tell them, we're a small church.
Oh, yeah.
Well, why y'all don't call them big churches? We don't have, but
why you know you pastor?
Y'all don't know it, but we have helped people that never been in the church, never see them no more. But God is good. God is blessing us.
That's right.
What we can do, we do. And everything. And we just, I thought y'all didn't take y'all test yet.
Hey,
y'all
took yesterday.
Huh?
Yesterday.
Oh, y'all took the test?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Johnny told me y'all was supposed to practice and then take the test, and y'all had to find out. Oh, y'all passed them, huh?
Yeah, but...
Oh, way to go.
We couldn't leave until we knew we passed.
Thank God it's over with.
Y'all wanted to get a certificate from the school, and then also the you get a thing saying you registered.
With Nuka?
Okay.
With Nuka? Okay. If you want to pay that money, you will. the joint Nuka, which is $34.37.50 now.
For what?
For Nuka.
And what benefits do you get?
You get your Nuka.
Let's talk about it after church.
Well, I let all hang out now.
You sure you can't edit that?
I want them to see the broad.
You know, get with them and we'll see what we can do.
Oh, yes.
All right, but you know, we're happy to see y'all, you know, graduating. Yeah. And, but one thing now, if we help you out, you remember, y'all got to remember these things so when other people come in, get on the Hershey board, y'all gonna teach them. We don't want Bob jumping up. We don't need that no more. So y'all professional, we got professional and professionalism in here now. We got some urgency. I tried to get Judy to stay along, but I don't want to work no more. Yeah, but it's good that we can laugh and we're trying to do some things and prepare for the future and everything. And God is good and God is great all the time. So I'm going to do an altar prayer and offer. Oh, Father God, we come with thanksgiving in our hearts. We thank you for allowing us to see a new day. This day we haven't seen was before, Father. We ask you to bless us and bless those that are going through problems and situations. Bless those that family is sick or down or bereavement, Father. We ask you to bless those new people that are coming in the office, Father. And I hate to say it, Father, but if we could, don't let Trump back in on whatever. But you know, what's best for us, Father. We're praying, we're still praying for a building. Some of the people that we have been praying for and looking for building have received building, and we thank you for that, Father. We're not trying to be selfish, and we're not trying to do just about us. We're opening minds and thoughts and praying for each and everybody in this building, and the sound of my voice have some situations or problems or something that's going on in their life, Father. And we're submitting, we're giving it to you, Father, to be a blessing. Reverend Wiley and others that are going through things and myself, but we just thank you for who you are, Father. We thank you for giving us what you have given us, Father. We thank you for being so good to us, Father. That's showing you how we can do, Father. We thank you for being able to do things that we weren't able to do a year ago, Father. But, Father, don't let us get too loose and get by getting money and start forgetting about you and start leaving you out of what we need to do, Father. Let us realize if it's from you, we wouldn't have this opportunity to increase in money or different things happening in our life, Father. Let us stop and think about you and put you in the right perspective and the first of everything, Father. Because without you, we will be nothing, Father. Touch our hearts and our minds, Father. Give us a blessing to see you in our lives, Father. Not just all churches opening your name, all people that even don't attend church that claim you, Father. We just say thank you, Father. Thank you for what you're doing. Well, thank you for what you're going to do, Father. We pray to help show people that they need you in their life, Father. let us stop and realize that if things weren't right, if you weren't in our hearts and our minds, what would this world be, Father? We just ask you to continue the blessing and continue to lead us in the right place, Father. We ask you to give us a building of our own and let the church grow to you, to you, your desires and your heart, Father. Let us have favor in your sight, Father. Let us just carry on with and be obedient to your word and your way, Father. Let us take time to just fast and read your word and work and be mindful for others, Father. And let us just be about, if we have to be nosy to just to be able to pray for other people, let us be nosy, Father. Let us be uplifting to one another, Father. Let us be encouraging and have hope, Father. And we just thanking you for not only Thanksgiving, we're thanking you for every day in our life, Father. We ask you these things and all things. In Son name Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Father God, we come to lift the offering up to you and lift it up to you that it'll be used for the missions and the different things that you would have, the uplifting of this church, the building of this church, and the members and the families, and represent you, Father. It's not about us, but it's about you, because you made us and you know us and you will put us in the right perspective, Father. If we can reach out and help someone, let us be able to reach out and help someone. Let us not put no one down or anything. Father, for those that don't have, we pray that they will come to a point where they have, Father, and give cheerfully, Father, knowing that what's given to this church is used to uplift them in this church. And as we grow, we might do outreach programs and different things that you would have us set up to do, Father. Let us stay within your wisdom, your knowledge, and your understanding. We ask you these things and all things. In Son's name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
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 Ushers, I'm coming. Thank you.
Give up and say how thankful you are. We
bless and praise and worship the Lord, just saying, and telling people what you're thankful for, what he has done for you within the last year, the blessings and how he brought you through the storms. And that's what all we're going to do today, and then we're going to get out of here. And I guess I won't see y'all no more till next Sunday because we ain't going to have Bible study, so I don't know about choir practice, but, you know, can we do that? We just can say thankful and be praised the Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, yes.
Can I go first?
Pardon me?
I want to go first.
Go ahead.
Okay. I'm normally quiet, but okay. I want to thank you, Pastor, for me and Johnny going to the class. It was hard. It was frustrating. Not because
and I was praying.
And we thank you for that prayer. And I thank each and everyone in this church. Everyone's so nice and kind. And everyone always got a kind word to say to you. And we laugh and we have fun. And I thank God for my family. We've been going through so many deaths, and we're still going through it. But God keep on bringing us close and closer together. And I don't have any kids, but I got nieces and nephews, and those are my heart. And I thank God especially for them. And that's my boo right there. So that's it. And thank you guys for everything.
I want to thank God for this year, for answering my prayers. I made a lot of doctor visits, and I want to thank him that none of them was really bad. I want to thank him for me finding this church this year. I want to thank him for everything that he's doing in our lives in this church and for this family, Pastor Snowden. I just want to thank him for just when I think he's not there or when I'm feeling so low that he just shows up just when I need him the most. And I just want to thank him for loving us, for loving me, and for waking me up every morning. Thank you.
I want to thank God for waking me up this morning. I want to thank him for family and friends. Thank him for you guys. And just want to know how much I appreciate it.
Amen. 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 I want to thank God for, thank you, Heavenly Father, for blessing us to be here this day and help and strength, because a year ago this time, I wasn't feeling as great as I feel at this time. So to me, it's just a blessing to be here and to look back and where you was in the past and where you are now, how much better I feel. So I'm just thankful for that. Blessing to see everybody, to be among a great body of brothers and sisters. So just thankful.
I want to thank the Lord for Evelyn Shaw for directing me to this wonderful church. If it hadn't been for them, I wouldn't have came. That's when it first started. And I want to thank you for the help of my son. He's still at home, still doing good, still walking, getting around. And I just want to thank him for all the love I feel every time I come in here.
Amen. Amen. Well, sis. Anybody else want to add 1 minute? I guess I can do three. First of all, I want to thank God for Love Community Baptist Church. You know, they say when you start to get perfect, that's when God will take you away. Mm-hmm. But every morning I wake up, open one eye, because Love Community Baptist Church has made me feel perfect. I've never felt so much love in my life.
Amen. Amen.
This is not, we talked about it in Sunday school. It's a family, brothers and sisters. And it's not words. We really are brothers and sisters. We seem to know what each other's thinking. We seem to know when one of us don't feel good. One of us is up and down. We are
family. And I want to thank God for that. I want to thank God for my other family that's okay. But but I just want to thank the love. I think I have seen more love in the last year than I've seen in the last 20 years. And I know it's because the people here genuinely love. And I thank God for that. Pastor Snowden, I think him and Johnny conspires against me sometimes. Talking, plotting, but
I thank God and praise Jesus Christ for bringing me mystery in my life, because I never knew that I was going to be in this church. I never knew I would meet so many nice people in my life. You know, I'm very when I could call a person my people, my friends and family, is a lot for me, because I really don't call nobody my people, my family, because it's hard to trust.
Yep.
And we don't know where trust is coming from, but we got to trust in the Lord to show us the right way to go. And that's the mystery that He can always give us. I met my wife 27 years ago. More than that. But 30 years. And she's been beside me ever since. No matter what I did, no matter whatever I said, she always knocked me on my head and said, "Wake up." But like I said, my first time meeting Mr. Snowden was when the day that I walked through the door. And what I'm trying to say is that God is wonderful. He had a wonderful son, Jesus Christ. And as long as we praise Him and praise Him and pray through Him, the mystery will always become the light. And I just praise Him every day. Although I do bad things, but I always praise Him when I want to do the right thing, and He always answers my prayers.
And not alone.
Amen.
And like I said, I'm happy to be with this church. This is my church, and you're all my family, and you're all my brothers and sisters.
Amen.
And may God bless every last one of you, and I'm proud to be here through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
As a Japanese, church is not close in my life. First time at this church I come, but something naturally, came to me. So I am very surprising, and I think God lead to here. So that's very appreciated.
I want to thank Rev. Mike Snow 8 years ago when I came to Love Community Baptist Church, and he told me, he said, "Well, we'll be some deacons." And I said, I always said, "Why I'm not ready to be one of these?" And I thought what a person said a long time ago. A person was saying, "I ain't come to church just to sit on the bank, don't do nothing, just be a part of it." And I'm so glad that Reverend Snow that got me on the right track, on the right road for the last 8 years. I've been coming to church. The only time I miss a Sunday is something really bad, you know. Otherwise, I'm here. I'm I'm so glad that I love to come to church. And that's a blessing. That's a blessing. Every Sunday, I never said a day about not going. I realize, thank you for that. I just want to thank you for got me on the right track. And Lord, I hope I stay on the right track for us. Amen.
Church has done a lot for my life. It really has. It's brought me closer in doing things, and sometimes I get overexcited on different stuff I want to do, and I have to just slow myself down. But I feel that we're all one big happy family. We laugh, we have fun, and we love one another. We look out for one another, and we think about one another. We come together to help one another grow. And I love that because I can just come here and just be me. I don't have to try to come and pretend that I'm somebody that I'm not. I love it because I'm accepted for who I am, Sheila. And that's what God sent me here to be, and I'm so glad that I'm here honoring my uncle for being in his church, and God has worked really good through Michael. He really has, and you just let him keep working through you. Because you're doing an awesome job.
Yes, it is. I'll go next. First, I want to say I'm thankful for God, for God being God, for who he is, for everything that he's blessed me with, for the things that he has seen that I don't need to have to be blessed with. second, I want to say I'm thankful for my immediate family. I'm thankful for this church family here. And for the most, I'm thankful for my dad. You know, my dad, he get on my nerves sometimes. I don't like it on his. Wear my patience out, but I'm thankful.
By yourself.
I always, you know, like, say if I'm talking to a guy or whatever, y'all know, because I ain't married, whatever. But if I'm talking to a guy, I always tell a guy, if he can't do half or be half of what my dad can be, then I don't want him. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to deal with you. And I tell a man with the quickness, besides my heavenly father, my earthly father is the only man that I got here that I can depend on.
Amen. He's coming. No question.
I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for God working with me, working through me, even though sometimes I know I even give the Lord a hard time when he trying to work with me and work through me, but he's still patient with me. I'm still a work in progress. Thank you guys for working with me. Thank you guys for letting me serve you guys and be here with you guys, and thank you.
You've done a good job.
Thank you.
Well, I don't know where I'd be if I wouldn't have found this church. And I guess we've been coming, what, 2.5 years
now? Yeah.
And I can't really say what each of you mean to me, but I thank you for accepting us. I thank you, Pastor Snowden, for teaching us, for being a person we can trust to teach us right. I thank the Lord for extending his arms to my family thousands of miles away in their healing, in their learning about Jesus. And I pray the next 2 years we don't have to hear politics. I can't tell you much. And the changes we've seen in people, just the whole feeling, it carries out. You know, where I work, it's all mixed races and everything. And sometimes I forget the sufferings, what you all go through, what you've been through in your families when it hits directly. it's, we have to believe in God. He's our only answer. And I thank you for this group we have here.
Thank you for always being there for me. And this church and everybody here. I'm not an easy person. But if it wasn't for you all, and the discussions make it easier for understanding Jesus and stuff, I'd still be in that lost evil world. And my sister and you all have been there for me. And you all don't know all the things you have broken through my mind that people out there use as an Old Testament to gain their evil ways. And if it wasn't for this church and you all, I'd still be that lost world. Amen. So I want to thank you for always being there. And next year I'm going to try to be easier. And I want to thank the pastor for always, and his family, for always being there for me. I mean, if it wasn't for you all, I have made progress, but not where I want to be. So I want to thank you.
We're all still a work in progress.
I give thanks to Pastor Carl, because I think if he didn't invite us to this church, I don't think I know where we would be right now.
Amen.
And that's what I'll have to be thankful for.
I want to thank God for blessing us all to be here and blessing my health to get better. Still ain't cut out the honey buns, but I
we can see that.
I'm just thankful for being here.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
I'm just thankful to be here and thankful for the friendship and love that I felt when I come through those doors and for the blessings that I receive.
Amen.
That's about it, isn't it?
That's it.
You haven't went.
I went all the time. I just want to say, this is truly blessing when you have people that love one another and seek to help each other. And that you can feel the love and the guidance and the different things that we reach out to help each other. And try not to put each other down. Even in my preach, I laugh and joke, but I don't want to put nobody down because I'm no better than nobody else in here. I have faults, I have problems, I have situations, but all I can ask you to do is pray for me. That God give me good health, pray that I stay in His grace. Pray that God give me the wisdom, the knowledge, and the understanding to help this church grow. And that each and every one of us, we're all in the ministry. We're all soldiers in God's army. And part of that is recruiting and reaching out to others. And when you start speaking about the church and your pastor and God, and people start seeing it in your hearts and your mind, you'd be surprised of people that want to come to church or want to come to see. Like I tell some women sometimes or some men that go to church, and if you come from church and you go back home, there should be a little difference or something about you. That should be where you ain't fussing or talking crazy to somebody. And when you start changing, people say, well, if God can change you, I want a piece of that. And we all should be able to have people that see changes in us and see up under conditions and circumstances that we don't get mad or get to hollering. We just stop and praise God and have God give us the words, the meditation, the words to say to people. We've been put down so much that we got to stop and realize that's the problem. People study putting people down, but we don't think about our mistakes, our wrongdoings, but we can point fingers at others. And we need to cut that out and pray for people. So quick to slice them up, but why don't pray for them? Pray them up. Prayer is our lifeguard. If you're drowning, you throw prayers out. Like if you throw a lifeboat out, a life verb out, that's our sword is prayer. And praying. And trying to be kind. Sometimes you can't. Sometimes it's best don't say nothing, just leave and pray. Because sometimes you can say some things and feel sorry later on. Best to sometimes just pray and walk away. Don't get no argument or this and that. And a lot of things you say and do, you don't know how it affects someone else. But ask God to give you the right conversation, the right way. Because there are some people, when you see them coming, you better start praying. Because they're going to have something to say. He asked Lord to bless you. But all I can say is, I'm thankful to be able to have the opportunity to be your pastor. And all I want to do is just pray for me. And let me stay in God's will. And give me the help and strength to do. And help us to march into our building with the two bathrooms, with the kitchen, with the Sunday school classes, with the also with the secretary, so I don't have to see her. I'm getting home. Keep on praying and have faith, have belief that God will, and he can, because it's his anyway. Everything we got, we just borrowing and using it, because we're not going to take nothing. If, you know, the funeral the other day, my little niece was nice and clean and everything, but they cremated her, but even with the cremation, all you see is that body in that coffin. That body ain't going to heaven. The part that's going to heaven is already gone. The part that's going to hell is already gone. And it's our job to try to enlist them in going to heaven and not hell. And we need to stop and think before we cut somebody down or say something. Let's pray. You know, if you're in an argument or sometime and you stop and say, let's pray about it, see how many people get quiet and say, okay. But pray anyway. Prayer is the key to all things. And God, we're not just, we celebrate Thanksgiving, but we have Thanksgiving each and every day God wakes us up. Regardless of what condition we're in or what's going on, we got to be thankful. As God better our lives, we got to pull closer to God. We got to be able to represent God more so. Because the things he's given us, sometimes God will test you to see, if I give you this, how would you react? See, God can give you a little just to see how much you will react with a lot. And you better be careful what you do when you see God blessing you. You better be thankful. You better stop and say, thank you, Lord.
That's right.
You done changed where I have a little change in my pocket, where I can do other things. You better stop and see. Are these other things interrupting your relationship with the Lord? We need to start praising him and realize that God is blessing us whatever we got. And if we work with him and have a relationship, what he gave us now is just a little of what he can give us if we do right with what he gives us and how he changed us. But I'm not going to say nothing more. We stand up and get out of here. And we're thankful once again for the Hershey's that graduated. We got professional. We got the musicians. We got the Hershey's, and we got our Sunday school director. We got our secretary. We like the Jefferson. We moving on up. God, we got our deacons. God is blessing us little by little. Little by little. Thank about it. What he had brought this church from to where we are now. Our goal is to build up and reach out and have God help us, help others, bring them into God. And don't let us think we know better than nobody else. But appreciate what God has given you. We're so busy trying to get something that we can't appreciate what we already got. Don't put nothing before God. Because if you don't put nothing before him, he will bless you with more than what you got. Because if he says you can handle a little, he's going to give you a lot. But if you can't handle a little, well, I got to go do this, I'm going to do that. But you done already said you were going to do something for God. Now you got a little bit and you ain't got time for him. What's going to happen when he say, I ain't got time for you? Think about it. Oh, Father God, we come to you with thanksgiving in our heart, Father. We thank you for allowing us to have this conversation, to just to praise you and magnify and glorify you, Father. We thank you for what you're doing in our lives, each and every one of our lives. We thank you for our family. We thank you for the family we represent. We thank you for this church, Father. We thank you for the growth that we're having and within this church, Father. We just ask you to keep us in your ways and in your direction. Let us begin to fast and read the word and meditate on the word and grow in your grace and mercy, Father. Let us be able to reach out to others and tell them about you, Father. Let us have a blessing of your word. Let the word of your mouth, our mouth, be on your side and meditate in our heart, Father. Let us be able to do what and pray for those that are sick, families are going through things, we can help instead of being selfish, this is mine, or this is, I don't need to help. Sometimes you need to help because somebody helped you. Regardless of where you was at, where circumstance you were, there was somebody help you in your life through that storm, Father. And we need to stop and be thankful, Father. We thank you. We just want to praise you, Father. And we just want to say thank you. Everybody just thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We appreciate you and we love you. And this we say, Lord, bless us on our way home or where we're going, Father. And I leave here to go to the hospital to be a little while. Let him meet him with joy and peace in the mind. Let us all have joy and peace in our mind that we can see clear to problems and see you there with the solution. We pray these things and all things in your Son, name Jesus Christ.